I want to use, if you will, this morning for a thought theme, or would you repeat it after me? Surrounded by enemies, but God delivers. Surrounded by enemies, but God delivers. Sometimes we find ourselves surrounded by people that say they love us, that say they're our friends, people that say the right thing, sometimes do the right thing, or at the right place, sometimes even at the right time, but only to find out that they truly are not our friends, but they are solely there for our detriment. They're there to mess us up, to disencourage, if you will. They're solely there, they're sent there by demonic assignment from the devil. How do you know that sometimes the closest folk to you are the ones that don't mean you no good? The folks that are surrounding around you that you think got your back are really there sent by the enemy to stab you in your back. So sometimes we find ourselves surrounded by enemies that we think are our friends. Surrounded by men and women that smile in our face, but all the time they try to take our place because they really are backstabbers. Surrounded by folks that every time you see them, they got a kind word, they're saying the right things, they're doing the right things. But in reality, we find out they are really our enemies that don't mean us any good, but really mean us harm, want to see our character assassinated, want to see our fame deflated, want to see, you know, our popularity taken down two or three notches, simply because they are haters. They are people that really don't like us. But then, on the other hand, there are sometimes that we're surrounded by evil circumstances. Stuff that we did not literally get involved in, but some kind of way, the circumstances, because that the devil meant for your evil, sometimes it permeates into your space, if you will, and you're surrounded by evil circumstances that you did not create, you did not make, you don't know how you got there, but God's over to tell you this morning, but the key is when you're surrounded by it, remember that God can deliver. Doesn't matter what the enemy's trying to do. Amen. The Bible said, declares that if God is before me, then who can be against me? Yes, I'm surrounded by the devil. I'm surrounded by his angels. I'm surrounded by people that smile in my face. I'm surrounded by folks and circumstances that don't mean me any good. But even though I'm surrounded by them, I'm still walking with God. I'm still, amen, in the hands of the man that changes things. I'm in the hands of the man that's able to speak life into death. So even though I'm surrounded by my enemies, I realize, but God can deliver. This particular text, if you will, is broken up into four parts. Number one, the psalmist complains in verse 1 and 2. Number two, his expression of confidence in God is found in verse 3 and 4. Number 3, his assurance of the Lord's protection is found in verse 5 and 6. Number 4, lastly, verse 7 and 8, he's closing in prayer. He takes time to pray and to thank God. But notice verse number 1. And y'all get ready, brother preachers, because you're going to help me close this text. The Lord, how are the increasingly that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. Notice here David is telling the Lord that I got folks that I don't know why they don't like me. I don't know why they're doing what they're doing. But they're rising up against me by the thousands. Only to find out, notice in your Bible, if you look up, above verse 1, it tells you, amen, that this is the son of David, and David, glory to God, this time is fleeing from his own son, Absalom, who has decided he wants his daddy job. Now, I can deal with sweat from our face, but all the time in your mindset, you're plotting like Absalom was doing, plotting against your own father, plotting, trying to get his job because you feel like I can do a better job. I'm going to let y'all know, but one leader at a time, I don't care how good you can preach, I don't care how much anointing you think you got, it ain't your turn yet, you better sit your behind. What they got to get what they want. If you flip back a chapter, in the 14th chapter, I see somewhere around 14 and 25. Put that up there for me. No, I'm in the wrong book. I'm in the wrong book. Go to 2 Samuel. Thank you. Holy Ghost. 2 Samuel 14 and 25. There we find out that Absalom was a good looking brother. Huh? No, the Bible, look what the Bible said. The Bible says, but in all of Israel there was none to be so much praised as Absalom. For his beauty. A hindrance because it was too heavy. So in the 15th chapter we find that Absalom began to use his beauty in order to get to the people of Israel to let them know I should be the king. I should be the one. Bible said he would meet them at the gate as they would come in. And can you imagine this brother who the Bible says from the bottom of his feet to the top of his head? You know, he take pretty boy to another level. Come on now.
Yes, he did.
See, it's all right for you to say he's fine, but the Bible says. Boy, fine. Call him Pretty Ricky. Huh? Pretty Absalom. I mean, use the word beautiful. My God, I ain't, you know.
Come on, man.
But he took his beauty and he began to use it in the 15th chapter. He began to let the people, as they came into the city of Hebrew, he would stop them at the gate and ask them what was their problem. They'd share what their problem was, and he said, well, if I was the judge, if I was the one that you brought your problems to, I'd make everything all right. The Bible says in the 15th verse of the seventh verse of the 15th chapter, I believe it is, it says that he found favor. He won everybody over. Well, see something there. Let me clarify something in this King James Version. It says, and it came to pass after 40 years. That's one of the few mistranslations in the Bible. Because if you know anything about David, David's reign wasn't but about 40 years. So there's no way that can be correct. But if you give me that same verse in Amplified, it will give the truth. 4 years. One of the few misnomers in the word. Notice it says there in the Amplified, it said, and after 4 years, Absalom said to the king, I pray you let me go to Herod his birthplace and paid my vows to the Lord. So it's good when you read God's word that you use some other books, some other translations, because sometimes things are lost in translation and it makes it easier for you to understand what's going on. But the text lets us know that this brother is so caught up in his own view until he wants to take over his daddy's kingdom. So much so until the text says that he won the hearts of the men. It didn't say women. It said that he won the hearts of the men of Israel. Because he would sit there and ask them questions and say, if I was in charge, I would tell y'all ever had anybody like that?
Yes.
If I was in charge, things would be different. If I was in charge, I would do it like this. If I was the one, I'm still talking about surrounded by enemies. But God can deliver. Brother Otis, come on, I'm going to take this a little higher because I'm going to throw this mic in a minute. Because how many of y'all today can attest to the fact that you have been surrounded by folk that have been faking? Surrounded by people that are really fake friends. Surrounded by those folks that really, really, amen, they're around you because of the fishes and the loaves, because of what you can do for them. And when the tables are turned, you can't find no help. There's some, I can't find nobody.
Nobody.
I can't find nobody. You money, but I can't find nobody.
Right,
I done bought you dinner, but I can't find nobody. Huh? I done helped you pay your bills, but I can't find nobody. Huh? I've been there when you were sick in the hospital, and now I'm sick, but I can't find nobody. Nobody coming to visit me. Nobody coming to giving me a birthday card. Nobody taking me out for dinner. I didn't spend money on life, dying, and everybody, but I can't find nobody. Sweat from my brow. Nobody is willing to say you look nice today. Nobody is willing to take me to the movies and let me buy some popcorn. I can't find nobody. Yeah, they love me like I love them. I can't find nobody that I can depend on. I can't find nobody that's got surrounding me in order to take me down. I found somebody that loved me anyhow. I found somebody that's a very present help in a time of trouble. I found somebody that's always there. Somebody that said, I'll never leave you, nor forsake you.
Trouble. I know this year. mature and complete, not lacking anything. Perseverance. You gotta persevere. You gotta go through. You gotta go through the haters. You gotta go through the backbiters, the backstabbers. I can be in the middle of war. You can look at me funny, I'ma praise some more.
I'm so
And you know I'm a woman that likes to wear heels. And so I went back to the doctor and they did an x-ray. They came back and told me I got arthritis in my knee. And the doctor told me that you need to stay off your knee. You need to stop walking. You need to stop bending on it. When it hurts, you need to ice it. You know, you need to take care of it. You need to pamper it. And I told the doctor, I said, okay, I hear what you're saying. He said, so what are you doing about your knee? What are you doing that you
surrounded by enemies. But God delivers. Doesn't matter what the devil means for evil. For the word of God says that there's no weapon that's formed against us that should be able to prosper when we put our trust in God. Because God is in control of everything. It doesn't matter. Because we're going to have enemies for the rest of our life. I don't care who you are. Somebody don't like you. Somebody plotting against you. Whether it be on your job, whether it be in your home. But as the text revealed, it's really, it hurts for when it's in your own house, when it's in your own family. I know I'm not the only one that has some family members that hate. Come on. Because God is blessing you, because God has placed you in a higher place. Your own family sometimes will talk about you. They'll scandalize your name. They'll tell you, you think you all that. But you know what I used to tell them? I'm not all that, but you know what? Yes, I am. Because I found out with God on my side, I am. Look at your neighbor and say, I am somebody. And I'm not going to let no enemy, even if it's my own brother, make me feel that I'm nothing. Make me feel that I'm less than a man. Because I know with God on my side, all things become possible to them that believe. I'm just wondering, is there any believers in here this morning? Right. Hallelujah. Because it's the enemy's job to surround us. Do you remember when I was a little boy, there was a song we used to sing, Jesus, build a fence all around me so that evil cannot harm me. Come against me, shall prosper. No, it won't. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. No, it won't. It won't work. No weapon. No weapon formed against me. Church where the Spirit of God is moving. Yeah. Right? Where you can feel the power of God. Yeah. Amen. Through His Word and through the people of God. Amen. Because that's what church is all about. I don't know about y'all. I don't come to church just to come to church. I come to get something. Man, after all the hell you gotta go through all week. Dealing with folks on a daily basis. I come to church, I come to a place where I can relax in the Lord and pray with God freely. Huh? Place where you gotta worry about nobody talking about me. Come into a place. That's why this is the church where everybody's somebody. But Jesus is the main attraction. We love one another. And most of all, we love God. Huh? And that's what it's all about, folks. And somebody wrote a song. I think it's called Go and Tell That.
Run and Tell That.
Oh, yeah. Run and Tell That. I want y'all to, all y'all, y'all Facebook folks, you get on Facebook today if you ain't already on there.
You run and tell them
how the service was today. You tell them, say, I'm telling you, woo! Huh? I might have been surrounded by the enemy, but God delivered me. free. Hallelujah. Let the social media know that God is yet moving in Queen Memorial. Praise God. Amen.